Final match of tonight's play coming up very shortly. Just a quick recap of what's happened previously. Kamie Serm, a comfortable 3-love victory over the young Alarabi. Tariq Momin, 3-1 battle with Zahed Salem to book his place into the semis. Nour El Shabini, 21-minute desolation of Freedom Mohammed to book her place into another.
هوية أول نصف النهائي لدى السيدات رح يجمع بين نور الشربيني من مصر وكامي سيغ من فرنسا. صار وقت نعرف هلا مين رح يواجه طارق مؤمن بنصف النهائي الأول لدى الرجال. So our first semi-final for the women is now clear. It's going to be joining between Kamie Serm and Nour El Shabini from Egypt. It's now time to know who's going to face Tariq Mu'min in the first semi-final in the men's. So introducing first a former world junior champion. He is one of the most talented young players on the PSA Tour and one of Malaysia's leading players in the sport, playing his first quarterfinal in the PSA Platinum event, currently ranked as the world number 18. Please welcome Ian Yao Ing. Ian will be facing a former world number one and a world champion who has won every major title the sport has to offer. One of the greatest players to ever play the sport, and it's his first time back at the pyramids since 2018. Currently, the world number two, they call him the Beast of Alexandria. Please welcome Mohammed El Shorbagi.
Well, the anticipation of this match now, Mohammed El Shabagi taking on one of his training.
received a proper lesson from his, I'll say, so-called older brother. I don't think that that's going to be the case here tonight. I think we're going to see a much, much stiffer opposition from Yao. He's been training in Bristol, as Joey said, and he will have learned a lot, not only in terms of improving his own squash and developing, but also about his opponent.
Enjoying the West Country, Yao. This is in Birmingham. What a setting, you can't beat it. All these viewers around the world watching this on Astra Sports, also on YouTube being aired. Please look to join Squash TV to follow the PSA World Tour, see how this tournament progresses, but also we've got a stack of events coming up. The US, San Francisco, US Open in Philadelphia. There is a lot of activity going on up until Christmas, so look to sign up. Support these players, support the sport, follow these characters as they develop. Hopefully we'll have hundreds and hundreds of thousands of Malaysians that are now going to be following the boy wonder, who is the next phase after Nicole David retiring from the women's game, as I mentioned before, with Ong Beng He and Muhammad Aslan Iskandar. Here's one Adnan, these very, very top players that were around for such a long period of time. John, I'm sure you played in Malaysia back in the day. You must have done.
I did. I played a few times there. I spent 2 weeks there sparring with Aslan and Kenneth Lowe at that time.
For a minute, I thought you were talking
not sparring
about,
in the ring.
As in leisurely sparring.
I wouldn't want to spar with Aslan. He was quite quick with his hands.
Thomas Porter from the Czech Republic. Take charge of this, very experienced.
Can we get a court service, please?
Yeah, I played in Malaysia as well. Terrific food, love the food out there. Very, very good food, Joey. Oh, it's making me very hungry thinking about it. Just having a quick wipe over the court because we're based on the Giza Plateau. The wind is really going. There's obviously a bit of residual sand that's coming on. Can't help that from being in the desert. Jordan, imagine if you were just kind of perusing YouTube and then you saw, not that you do peruse YouTube, I'm sure you do actually, but you saw this match popping up on somewhere and you just suddenly think, oh, I'll have a look at that, and then you see the pyramids in the background and it's like, wow, this is looking a bit interesting. I might have a look at this sport, see what's going on. Luckily enough, you get to see one of the best players of the modern era with Mohamed El Shabagi
CIB
in his
Egyptian
all
Egyptian Open 2021. Men's quarterfinal match. In Yaoung of Malaysia to serve, Mohamed El Shabagi of Egypt to receive. Best of five games.
Very intelligent young man, Yao.
Lovell.
He's going to be kicking off this. He's got to be tactically sound. They know each other's game very well. Trained on a daily basis in Bristol. Johnny, the intro to this quarterfinals this evening, you were saying that he didn't feel there was going to be any scalpings or upsets this evening. You've been correct so far. And you're still sticking to your guns there.
I am sticking to it. I like the way that Yao absolutely sprung out of the blocks here like a sprinter. He means business, and I do feel that's a wonderful shot though from El Shabagi. I do feel that Yao, just based on what those recent results and what he's done here, I just feel he's going to make a really good account of himself. I think he's.
I hope so, Johnny. I really do. I hope we don't, you know, it can be difficult when you've you're training with someone that's that bit older than you and has achieved so much in the game, to be a little bit passive and kind of give a little bit too much respect. I mean, he's obviously he conducts himself very well on court, but he's got more of an aggressive edge about him, Yao, in this last phase as he started to get some results. The belief factor's there. At the end of the day, he took out Mustafa Asal 3-love, and Mustafa Asal beat Mohamed El Shabagi in the World Tour Finals to win that major title back in Cairo in June. So, you know, he's got to have some confidence. The pressure will be on the beast who's dealing with it.
Three block.
Pretty immaculately so far.
Yeah, that was a massive shutout. Just letting little boy wonder know that you give me a bit of space on that forehand, there'll be no friendly. No, it's not a friendly match here.
Well, he did say he was like a little brother to him, so he is actually going to take whatever he can. And kind of a bit of a warning sign. It's like, no, I don't. No, please don't. I don't want to be the younger brother. Don't say that.
This is a very, very impressive start, though, from
Paul
the
Love.
Most prominent player of the last, certainly last decade. Took his own ups and downs, El Shabagi Joey. He's sort of, he announced at Elguna, that's an incredible shot as well, that he had
five
lots of stuff
love.
Still to do in squash, and then he followed through on that, but he was not able to, from a very strong position in that World Championship final, close the deal. British Open, just left wanting a little bit mentally in that semi-final, so. Obviously, 15 years on the tour does wear you down at some point, but.
Six, love.
Well, he doesn't look worn down here. He looks, he's in his fresh whites and he's looking very sharp and hungry.
Exactly what Yao needed after
head
that
out.
Absolute onslaught
one,
from
six.
El Shabagi. Nice cross court, Nick, just forcing the error.
Well, he's certainly letting Yao know what it's like to be at the top of the tree. Not just in a training practice match down in Brithel.
Well, this is... Oh. A bit of a bump there, but El Shabagi, I mean, compared to what we saw when he played El Hamami in the previous match, in terms of that passive sort of trying to find his way in the early stages, he's come out all guns blazing, Joey.
Yeah, but it's calculated as well. He's got that physical presence, so he's really asserting on Yao, but he's also hitting with the quality. It's the first one.
2-6.
Waiting for someone just to take their seats. Chased by a mosquito.
Yeah.
Yao played both his matches at the Squash Centre, so this is his first ever time on the glass court here at the Pyramids. It's going to be slightly daunting, isn't it, Johnny? I mean, it's just such an exceptional setting.
I don't think he's getting much of a look at those pyramids, though, through the front wall, because all he can see is a big white shirt of El Shabagi in front of him right now. Absolutely thundering on the ball. Producing a very, very high tempo of hitting. Look at that.
Goodness me, this is absolutely savage.
But, I mean, I'll throw it back to you again. Even if he hasn't played El Hamami before, why would he not come out with this approach in the previous match? I honestly don't understand.
Because he's never played El Hamami. He's playing his practice partner here.
Well, the approach is the approach at the end of the day, irrespective of who you're playing.
There's a huge familiarity, though.
Yes, and,
you know, he does have this... I told you when he was playing El Hamami, which
Eight,
was the previous round for Mohamed El Shabagi.
Player review.
When he doesn't play a player,
on the Yesler
does
decision.
Get a little bit initially, a little bit nervous. But there's no nerves in this familiar contest. Look here. He's not really cleared this, is he?
No, he's actually walked forward a little bit there and sold himself into a whole heap of trouble. This could be
clear.
Lucky.
Could have been interpreted.
Yes, let decision upheld.
There's a possible stroke penalty point
remaining.
Against
Eight,
Yao.
Two. But
being that.
Well, maybe El Shabagi's aware that this has gone out
Nine,
being aired
two.
On YouTube to a lot more viewers, and he wants to show that he is the world number one for a reason. Ridiculous tempo, Joey.
Well, I'd like to say, it's like just a white sight screen in front of Yao. Got no idea, can't get in front of him at the moment.
that's a straight kill into the nick with a bit of angle. And this is one of the most.
Well, he's not played badly here, Yao. It's just Mohamed El Shabagi playing quite immaculate squash. Oh.
11-2. Game to El Shabagi. El Shabagi leads.
Well, the beast is hungry. Will there be a slight drop off from Mohamed El Shabagi, the current world number two, but the number one seed for this event? Former world number one and world champion. He's won every event under the sun and more. He's looking to win his first title at the Pyramids.
Would Yao be well served in just trying to mix the pace a little bit more? He's been trying to play quite a click with El Shabagi in that first game. Just use a bit of height and angle to get out of trouble as well.
Yeah, I mean, he's not going to out-muscle Mohamed El Shabagi. There's just no chance of that, but definitely use a bit more height. The most important thing is to try to get Mohamed El Shabagi away from the middle of the court, the T position, that central position where the lines meet. That's the area that the players look to stand and dominate from, and Yao needs to try and get in front and get Shabagi into the back of the court. See the mobility of Yao, he's hugely gymnastic, very fast, terrific athlete. It's a good decision. He's way off. Just can't get in front of him. The fact that they are training partners, Johnny, you've also got to take into consideration that they train on the traditional courts, the glass-back courts.
Yeah, and it's a
big difference between those and a court, an all-glass court in the outdoor environment.
And this is what, obviously, El Shabagi's been banking on with this game plan, that the severity of his play. He's not playing any kind of conventional game. It's very, very super aggressive. Hunting the ball down. If you can back that up with this kind of quality of hitting, what he's showing tonight. Very hard for Yao to find an inroad here, but he's just trying to perhaps slow it down. El Shabagi also opting for it. First time we've seen this, just a bit of probing down that left-hand wall. It's So important here that Yale can just find a couple of physical rallies and get some work into the legs of El Shabagi as well. Completely just turned the accelerator off.
They're just mixing. You know,
it's going to be a stroke.
Oh, cool.
Head out. 1-3.
Good from Yao, just being a bit, taking a strong position there and.
Yes, sir.
Shabagi's at his most confident when he's mixing these paces, of course playing physically, but he's now just taking a little bit of a bit like kind of fartlet running, Johnny. Interval running. Bit of a surge, and then take it back a little bit, and then a bit of a surge. Looking to play with a bit more control here, Shabagi. Weighted strokes to the back of the court.
Oh, it's a wonderful shot there. Everything was pointing towards El Shabagi. Getting ready to really cane that ball cross court. But look at the way he just opens his body up and then changes the angle very late. So adept at using that hold very, very late on that forehand drop. Usually does it at the front.
Still in touch here, Yao. Just two points behind in this second game.
Just forcing it though, the last couple of rallies. So this is good from Yao. He's methodically just working his way back in.
Well, telling Thomas Ford to just kind of relax, which is not in Thomas's nature. You can see if we cut to him how upright he is when he's sitting, hugely stiff and tense. But a very experienced referee. Yao's endurance qualities are very high. It's a bit of an appeal there from Shabagi.
Yes, lad.
Oh, my God. Oh! If you. Well, Shabagi furious with that. There's see Thomas sitting. Very tense posture. A bit fortunate, I feel, Johnny, just, you know, looking at that first time.
Can we get a court service, please?
There.
Yeah, he's got a problem there, Yao. He's going diagonally forward, the ball's straightening up and going towards. That angle supports it a bit, bent more for a lead. This angle looks like Yao's sort of going slightly on the wrong line, but what do you think here, Joey? There,
I tell you,
it's tight.
Any viewers that are watching the sport for the first time are slightly confused because we are.
Well, I don't think that it can be awarded. It cannot be upgraded to a stroke with such a tight drop like that. But yeah, I'd be given the benefit of the doubt. No, he's not been given it.
No, I wouldn't have given a stroke.
No lead decision overruled. El Shabagi has one review remaining. Head out. 5-3. The ball was a winner.
So the explanation why it was a no-let was that they felt the ball from Mohamed El Shabagi was too good a winner.
I feel it was more about the line from Yao going diagonally forward, slightly off.
He's pushing up here though, Yao. He's trying to battle for that central position at the moment. He's better from the Malaysian.
He didn't deal with that forehand. He's got to be careful. He can't leave it half court.
Yes, sir.
It's a very good width. It's a very good width. I think that's a little bit soft to ask for a let ball from such a good width. This was deeper in the back of the court and lower.
It's a classic professional let, Joey, there from El Shabagi.
Yes, sir. 5-3.
Goodness me, you can hear the wind again, Johnny. We are very high up here on the Giza Plateau.
Another error. We've seen a few of those from Shabagi trying to force that half-volley boast in this game.
Well, the stately manner, the immaculate first game from Mohammed El Shabagi, now starting to drop off, and Yao starting to get the bit between his teeth. He's looking busy, and that's a stroke, Johnny.
5-4.
Well, I think based on what we've seen from these results, you know, beating Asal, that he was not going to get flustered after being blasted off the court in game one. So if there was any drop off from Shabagi, I'm definitely expecting that Yao was going to work his way in. But again, that powerful forehand, it's that mid-court forehand. He's leaving it short, Joey, and it's a troublesome area. Here, he's got to make sure he gets that ball through if he's going cross. Cannot leave it around the short line. Shabagi with a short backswing can feign the drop in and then, or just thunder it with that power.
Well, the maintenance team just coming on to secure. Oh my word, look at that. You can see the sand from the last mop. Look above the graphic there of Mohammed El Shabagi. Look at that, Johnny. There's the sand that's being blown onto the court because where we are, and it's right on that service box, right by the foot of Yao.
6-5.
There's a massive amount of sand there.
Are you sure it's not the back reflection on the back wall there?
No, no, they found another pyramid.
I think they'd be very concerned if they would be running into that sand patch, that's for sure. Oh, Shabagi choosing, he was looking for his opponent and the ball swirled around. This is better for Yao. That was a good working
It's more
rally.
Aerobic. Yep. It's more aerobic, Johnny. Yep.
And out.
Suiting the lighter 6-4. Frame of Yao.
And Shabagi doesn't have that push onto the ball at the moment. This is very, very good work from Yao. Just again.
Stroke to Shabagi.
Very unfortunate there, Yao. He worked the rally beautifully, ripped in some boasts,
but
just struggled to find that line down that forehand side when he's been presented the opportunity.
He's starting to bend over now. Right, we just see the mopping there. We'll just see if this area in the service box. It does, he's just stepping all over it. Surely he's going to mop it up. I'm determined to, because I'm not, I know we're in the desert, but I'm not starting to see like mirages. He's missed it again.
He mopped straight through there, Joey.
No, he didn't, Johnny. No, he didn't, mate.
Can we please
There we go again. He was in there. Nothing happened.
He won't.
Next time.
Why is he not going to the massive bit of sand? It's across the service box. Can't believe. No.
I don't know what you think. Thank you. Hand out, 7-6.
This is really tidy stuff here from Yao. I'm very impressed now by the way he's responded, Johnny.
Well, it's become a lot more aerobic the last period of play. Before that interlude with the mopping of the court, he was working El Shabagi nicely around the court. He was using the boast as well. But again, I say it again, Joey, right-hand side, mid-court.
Yeah, he's on just that volley area.
Eight,
El Shabagi has got such a wingspan on him. He's over 6 foot in stature, very, very long levers, and he pounces on those volleys, particularly the forehand side. So if Yao is going to go cross-court, he's got to get it high and wide. Oh, he's mishit that one, and it's given a
9-6.
3-point lead now for Shabagi in the second.
Well picked up. Great pressure though from El Shabagi. He's all over him here.
Oh, he's hit the tin. He looked. He wanted to see where Yap was. He went for the very fine margin with the boast.
Seven.
Made the error.
Just feel that the good work that Yao did in the mid part of this game he's undone it himself. I mean, against other players, perhaps he could afford to leave the ball in certain areas, but against the absolute best, there are areas of strength that you just cannot put the ball into.
Down.
That one's gone down as well. So he's lost that impetus that he had, Yao. Fought back well, got back to 6-all. And now Shabagi's moved away nicely to 3 game balls.
Seven.
He only needs one opportunity, Mohamed El Shabagi. Capitalising. Definitely looked like there was a slightly worrying time for Shabagi at the mid stage with Yao responding, but all that experience from the Egyptian shining through. ...25 minutes in this last quarter-final at the top half of the draw. And it's now Mohamed El Shabagi leading the Malaysian number one, Yao, by 2 games to love.
Well, it was a better game from Yao. He provided that opposition that we knew was coming. El Shabagi was trying to keep that tempo up very high, and then he started to slow it down to the mid part of that second game. He probably had to. He knew he was not going to be able to keep going at that rate. But Yao at 6-all was perched to perhaps make a bit of a move, but El Shabagi closed it out beautifully. That feathering, that drop in. He's leading very strongly now, 2 games to love.
That was the crucial time, Johnny, that mid stage.
And that rally
surge.
At 6-all was an absolute monster. Yao was moving Shabagi to all parts of the court. He had a forehand volley, needed to put it down the line, and he left it in the middle of the court. And El Shabagi, it'll be interesting to get the cross-court analytics numbers on El Shabagi's winning, where his winning shots are coming from. There will be a high percentage coming from that mid right-hand court area.
Music, please. Short buggy leads, 2 games to love.
This last quarter final, the top half of the draw. Mohamed El Shabagi leading Yao by 2 games to love. Very, very confident start
love
for the number one seed and current world number two.
Now, hand out. 1-0.
Too risky there from Yao. He chose the
2-1.
Rather ambitious cross-court nick here. That was the corner that Shibagi was already standing, and he used a great counter there. So Shibagi just maintaining control. He's been able to keep. That's a well. That's interesting. Yao is absolutely adamant that he got his racket under this, and he may have.
Mr. Ung's ball in the back left corner.
Yeah, he was, you could tell by the reaction of Yao, felt that that ball was clean, only bounced once. We'll have a look here. No, it was okay, Johnny. It was okay. Certainly didn't bounce twice. Would you concur?
That was definitely up. Got his racket under it, no problem whatsoever. It's got to be a let ball.
Yep. Ball was called good. Yes, let. Hand out 2-1. Down. 3-1.
Can't afford to give unforced errors like that to Shibagi. Just going to make his cause even tougher. And Shibagi's taking full advantage when the ball's loose, Johnny. Yao's tee position has gone further back in the court. You see he's quite deep there around the back of the service box area.
Yeah, it's been a proper lesson from world number two to his training partner, who's done very well to move up to number 18 in the world, but he's just out of his depth here. Tactically, it was a masterclass in game one. Shibagi, haven't seen him do that for quite a while, playing at ferocious tempo just to put his younger opponent on his heels. Successfully did that. Yao made a good push in game two, but that was fended off as well. Now he's got literally, it's Mount Everest, because he's just not working for him at all, Joey.
No, this is a tough call out there for Yao. Shibagi on the rampage. He wins this, which he looks like he's going to do. He'll be taking on Tarek Momen, former world champion, the semi-finals on Thursday, live on Squash TV.
Out 2-7.
Characteristic there, Shibagi, just misjudging that one.
Down 3-7.
Mini sort of look in here for Yao. Shibagi's looking to close this out very quickly. He's looking for that press very hard to the front wall.
Yes, left. 3-7. Court service, please.
So we're going to have another court wipe. Make sure all the sweat and sand is collected. Just on the face of it, Joey, based on what we're seeing from El Shibagi here, he's showed some very, very good form tonight. And perhaps Tarek Momen just off the boil a little bit. You feel like Momen's going to, if they meet each other in the semis as it's looking, that Momen's going to have to, he's going to have to really have a good game plan out there. He's going to have to play some serious good length to get his positions.
Thank you.
If he plays El Shibagi.
No, I mean, without question, but I feel that he's got a good opportunity. He's got a good chance against Mohamed El Shibagi. Mohamed El Shibagi
three,
you know,
seven.
Played the World Championships, which Moman did as well, losing out narrowly to the eventual winner, to Ali Farag. Didn't play the British Open, as we said. Came back home, been with his family, rested up a bit, trained, just been in one time zone. I think he can trouble Shivag. He needs to make it physical. He needs to play to his strengths and make it aerobic and physical. But the adaptability of Muhammad is second to none, and he's shown that here tonight. And yeah, that very impressive movement here from Yao. Goodness, oh my word, this is quick.
Stop.
Wow, that was so, don't stop the rally. That was so exciting.
Shivaggy is furious here, Joey.
Court service, please.
What a party pooper. Yao is just getting quicker and quicker. Thomas, no, you really are a spool sport. That, he was getting quicker and quicker, Yao. At one point, I thought he was going to head over the top of the Great Pyramid. This was unbelievable from Yao there. And then he got quicker here. This movement was unbelievable. And then again. And then he wanted to go for another one.
But he was quite relieved.
He literally had finished the ball here. Sorry, after this one there, there's, and then the backhand volley drop winner. Well, we're having a look at this. Johnny? They're looking,
the pickup now.
Well, all the pickups were very good from Yao. Very, very good indeed.
Just got his end of his racket under it, but it was up. Right. See there, just got the racket under it. Yeah. It's very fine, but he managed to get the end of that Dunlop racket, and that is
all
why
good.
It's been reaffirmed.
Yes, lad, 3-7.
Shivaggy not messing around, looking for that quick fire attack. Wants to finish this off briskly. Oh, what a shot from Yao. Beautiful hold.
Everything
stopped, including his body. See this on the replay. Very hard to control the ball like that.
Down.
Oh, an error, Joey. Maybe, I hope we didn't speak too soon. Back to 5-7.
Well, you know the old saying, Johnny.
Not over till the fat lady sings. Is that the one? And then Shibagi's also well adept at using fantastic hold in that front right corner.
5.
Yeah, unable to clear there, Yao, so El Shivaggy
9-5.
Getting back on course nicely, 9-5. Fortunately for Yao, he just was unable to push Shivaggy deeper in the court and build on that successful period he had in game two. But he'll learn from it.
Yes, lad.
A bit of a pause from Thomas Forter on that one. And now it's being reviewed. Yao feels it's a stroke to him and not a let ball. I think he's got a point there from that angle. Muhammad El Shivaggy feels it's a lot shorter. And this will be shown by the sky view. And it does show that it is a bit shorter, but it's pretty loose as well, Johnny.
Problem is Shivaggy's movement off the ball is back to the tee. So he was
taking away the line of Yao there. Possibly. Well, they need a good look at this because this could easily be seen as a stroke.
You would think 9.9 times
yes,
out of 10 it would be a stroke, but it's not.
9-5.
That's not a good decision, I don't think. But in the context of what's happening here. It doesn't really play a role, you wouldn't think.
Well, we know how gutsy Yao is. That was evident in his 12-10 victory over the Colombian Cannonball in the last 16. That is quite exquisite, but this is a big service here for Yao. He cannot look to tee the ball up onto the racket of Mohamed El Shabagi because it will only go one way and it will be a cross-court nick attempt.
It's close.
Yeah, it was very close.
Interesting that Yao's shot playing arm has just freed up a little bit in this last phase. The pressure released, sort of facing the inevitable, but just again, it's plagued him as well.
Yeah, it has.
Seven.
He just kind of left himself a bit too much to do. Three match balls for Mohamed El Shabagi to book his place into the semi-finals of this Egyptian Open on Thursday, live on Squash TV. Oh, he's managed to keep his footing. He couldn't get that one.
And out.
He wants it mocked. He slipped on the sweat. One last mop, Johnny, possibly, is it?
It was a big slip, that's for sure. He was slip sliding away.
It's a lyric, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. I just thought that
Oasis?
As well.
Oasis?
No, it will come to me. Paul Simon, there you go. Thanks for that feedback.
I said it, you didn't, you've just
comes
nabbed
from
that.
A song. I don't know, I'm trying to think of the name of the song, but we've got a lot of viewers out there. Feel free to write in and tell us the name of the song. I don't think it's called Slip Sliding Away. But this is close to slip sliding away for Yao.
Again, another hugely crucial service to the backhand side this time. Two match balls with Mohamed El Shabagi.
Video referee decision on Hong's appeal.
Well, the Thomas Forter has thrown the ball over to the video official on match ball. Mohamed El Shabagi's played this ball. It stayed very, very tight. Yao's blocked behind him. Oh,
going forward a bit, Joey Yao.
I know.
I'm sure he's taken the right leg. We had that situation before.
Oh,
ball's running
Johnny.
Deep. Ball's running deep.
Could be all three decisions. Could be a let, could be a stroke, could be a no let.
I would rule,
what would you
I'm
give?
I'm ruling out stroke.
It's okay, well, you're narrowing it down. This is good, Johnny. I like working with you. Keep going.
I think that Yao has stretched, though, to get the let, and that's why it's been
no let.
So the no let
11-8
has been
match
given.
To,
and that means Mohamed El Shabagi finds himself in another semi-final of a major event, this time in Cairo. Good experience, though, for Young Yao from Malaysia, who's moving up the rankings from tournament after tournament. First time for Yao in the quarterfinals of an event here at the Pyramids in Egypt. 41 minutes, though, for Mohamed El Shabagi to overcome the boy wonder, as he's known, 3 games to none.
Yeah, Mohamed El Shabagi was in control of this third game. Yao's resistance had broken after that second game where he had a bit of a look in. El Shabagi just sort of made a few errors sort of late in the game, which kept Yao in it. Yao sort of loosened up, played some nice shots as well, but he was always out of touch, 2 or 3 points behind. Shabagi just did enough to get himself over the line. He'd be very happy to get through 3 games to love for yet another cracking semi-final set up against his rival, Tarek Momen. And that is going to be a great match coming up in 2 nights' time.
Well, it's confirmed the top half of the draw now. It's the battle of the two Egyptians, both former world champions. The number 3 seed, Tarek Momen, taking on the number 1 seed, Mohamed El Shabagi. Again, that will be live on Thursday night here in Cairo. And then tomorrow, we will see part two of the quarterfinals in the bottom half of the draw. Paul Cole, the British Open champion, winning that prestigious event just a couple of weeks ago. He'll be taking on the younger brother of Mohamed El Shabagi, Marwan. And the Black Falcon will be up against Ali Farag, the number two seed and current world champion and current world number one.
So it's going to be interesting to see if the younger brother El Shabagi can produce the sort of form that he did to win the Black Ball Open, where he had a mammoth 3-2 victory over Cole on his way to winning that.
Well, just to reiterate the lineup for tomorrow, the second part of the quarterfinals in both the men's and the women's. Amanda Sobey of the USA kicking off against Hani of Egypt. Paul Cole, the number four seed from New Zealand. He'll play Marwan El Shabagi. Hania El Hamami, young sensation from Cairo, the number six seed. She'll play the Terminator, the number two seed, Narongo Ha. That could be a belting match there, Johnny. And then the Black Falcon, one of the most talented players on the men's tour. He'll be playing Ali Farag, the current world champion, at 8:30. But Mohamed El Shabagi is now down at courtside. Let's hear from him and Natalie.
Mohamed El Shabagi, congrats on booking your seat in the semis. You practice with Yao back in Bristol. Do you approach players that you train with any differently than any other player?
Yeah, actually, because we practice. There are three players that I practice with the most in Bristol: Joel Makin, my brother, and Yao. But Yao is the most I practice with, actually, out of the three of them. Some days we practice twice a day together. Today, you know, he's young, he's hungry. He's a younger brother to me, and he's probably the only one beside my brother I would say that, you know. And I care a lot for him, and I think because I do care a lot for him, I wanted to be really aggressive and play really, really well and make it really tough to show him how tough it is at the top. So he learned it's not easy to get there, and that there is, even though that this is his first quarter final, I just wanted to show him there is still a long way to go. I'm really happy for him to make it to his first quarter. He almost did it at the British. He did it here. And there is so much more to come from him. You know, I know his attitude back in Bristol, how he trained, and he's really hardworking. He's really committed to the sport. And he's gonna go to places, you know, in this sport, I'm sure.
Hamad, how does it feel for you to be back at the Pyramids for the first time since 2016?
I know, you know, it's been 5 years. Unfortunately, I missed the last 2 years due to circumstances out of my hand, and I'm glad to be back here again. This is the most iconic tournament in Egypt we have, and, you know, I watched Barada playing when I was 7 years old, so I've always dreamt to be on court like him, you know, and I think not just me, all the Egyptians playing right now. We all watched him when we were kids, and, you know, to be back here playing the semis, and really, really proud to come back, you know, make it that far, but still, we're getting into the most important part of the tournaments now, the later stages, and that's when most of the top guys raise their level, and I expect that of myself in 2 days.
Well, thank you so much. Congratulations, and good luck for the rest. Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Well, interesting to hear there with Mohamed El Shabagi just lining up his training partners with Joel Makin, sadly, who's not playing in this event, Johnny, but his brother certainly is. Marwan El Shabagi is coming up tomorrow. But I mean, again, we say this, the Egyptian Open is one of the major tournaments on the PSA World Tour. It's got a rich history, but it's also got the most spectacular setting with these great pyramids behind us. But it's a pretty quick fire night of squash here, Johnny. I mean, you did predict it was going to go on seedings. You don't always get it right, but you certainly did tonight. And I mean, it was probably a bit more straightforward than I actually thought. I thought there'd be a bit more of a battle going in with some of those quarterfinals.
Yeah, I thought that Yao, he had a small look in that last match at 6-all in the second. There was a big rally which he should have closed out and he didn't. But yeah, it just shows that, you know, he's got a long way to go. He's had a couple of good wins there. But El Shabagi, he was unbelievable in that first game. And that was an absolute battering. I haven't seen El Shabagi produce that kind of squash absolute cracking tempo. If he can do that, if he can continue to do that for the rest of the tournament, he's going to be very hard to stop, even for Moman.
Well, he'll be coming up against Tariq Moman, who won the four-game match with Zahed Salem. I mean, those guys have played a lot over the years, Moman and Mohamed El Shabagi, and it's another opportunity for Tariq Moman to try and win his first platinum event. He is a former world champion, but I mean, he's got to prove himself against Mohamed El Shabagi. They've got a day's rest. Not that the players tonight necessarily need that, because it's been so straightforward, but they'll be waiting. I mean, how do you think that will fare with the whole day to wait for somebody like Tariq Moman? Do you think he'll relax out a little bit, or be wanting to get stuck in and crack on?
I think that it'll do him the world of good. I think that he had a very clean performance against Iker in the two nights ago. But tonight there was a few things that he just was, the radar was a little off. He was making too many unforced errors. I think that this rest day, a practice, that will be a good reset for him. And I think he needs it going into that semi.
Well, just going back to the women's competition for this Egyptian Open, you can see Noor El Shabini, known as the Warrior Princess. She's the number one in the world, current world champion, winning everything under the sun. And she's got through, Johnny, in over 60. She's played 67 minutes of squash in the entire tournament to take on Camille Serme, who we know is struggling with Achilles tendon tendonitis, and she can't move. And that's a massive part of her game. I mean, booked in at the top of the draw there. And of course, we're awaiting the bottom half of the draw, which actually looks like it could be some really tough matches coming up tomorrow in the women's.
Yeah, Sobi Hani. Sobi's had the wood on Hani. She's beaten her four times, but Hani, is she due for a victory there? I'll take a good look at that one before I make my prediction. Noorang Gohar, I mean, she gave Hani a bit of a lesson in the Alguna International. Moving over to the men's there, Joey.
Yeah, I mean, Mohamed El Shabagi is obviously in with Moment. You're looking at the bottom half. Marwan El Shabagi is due a big tournament. Paul Cole on cloud nine with his best squash, winning the biggest tournament of his career, the British Open. You've also got Ali Farag, who loves playing in his own backyard as well. So, I mean, again, I think we're looking at a real tantalising quarterfinals. It'll be, I feel, a lot different to what we've seen tonight, Johnny. I think we'll have some serious scraps in both the women's and the men's quarterfinals tomorrow here at the Pyramids.
Yeah, definitely. The Black Falcon, he's looking inspired. He seems to be clear of those injuries that plagued him for a long time. He's going to provide stiff opposition for Farag. Farag's going to have to really get it going. And Paul Cole against Marwan, I'm still leaning towards Paul Cole. I think that he's got that confidence now to really stamp that approval of that British Open.
So you're still going with seedings in both the women's and the men's for tomorrow's
results? Well, give me a night's rest and I might change my mind, but pretty much. I have to say, I love listening to Mohamed El Shabagi. I love the fact that he mentioned Barada. He's a good student of the history of the game, and Barada and Pyramids, they kind of belong for me. I remember coming in the late 90s, and Barada playing in front of the Pyramids, that's what kicked all of this off, really.
It certainly did, and we can't wait for tomorrow. It'll be live on Squash TV for the second part of the quarterfinals of this CIB Egyptian Open. We're now going to say goodnight from the most spectacular sporting venue in the world, I have to say. Join us again tomorrow.